to my podcast, What the Fuck Just Happened. My name is Liz Enten, and I'm about to share the craziest thing I have ever learned. I have come to think that there's an afterlife. Okay, so a lot of people think that, but if you knew me, I'm not spiritual. That's why it's kind of a surprise that I've come to think this. Culturally, I'm a Jew. I like my bagels, but I don't believe in God, never have. I need actual evidence. I'm not gonna believe anything unless I see valid evidence. How did someone like me even come to think that there's an afterlife? That's a lot more complicated than I can just explain in this intro, but that's what this podcast is about. So here's at least a brief summary. In 2015, my dad died, and yeah, that sucked just as much as you could imagine. In my desperation and grief, I took a shot in the dark and decided to see if there was any valid evidence of an afterlife. The very first thought I had was that if our neurons of our brain create consciousness, why could that not happen another time in, say, 200 years? And while I'd be a different person, I could still at least experience being a person. So I Googled this, and I was shocked to discover there are two child psychiatrists who are professors at major universities studying cases of kids with past life memories. These are normal, intellectual, science-minded psychiatrists. I dug further, and I came across science-minded researchers who were testing psychic mediums to see if they could get accurate information under strict controls. And spoiler alert, they could. I was blown away. I had to see this for myself. So I went and got a bunch of my own medium readings. Yeah, I know how weird that sounds, but I took precautions. I used controls, hiding my identity, such as a fake name, a Google Voice number, everything that they could possibly use to find out who I was or cheat, I hid. And as expected, some of them were complete bullshit. But some of them knew shockingly accurate things, such as the name of my dad, that my cat had just died, my dad's personality, and even some specific memories I had shared with him. I was blown away. What the fuck was going on? And I continued to research and learned about all this batshit stuff, such as experiments demonstrating we all sense events are going to happen before they do, and just a whole other body of research that challenges our understanding of the very nature of time, consciousness, and just how our whole world works. All of this made me feel kind of like I had stumbled upon a secret hidden world, the kind we dream about as children. Or maybe like I discovered a new color I'd never seen before. I kept expecting to find the catch, but the further I dug, the more and more mind blown I became. And my definition of what's possible versus impossible slowly began to change. In this podcast, I'll be speaking with everyone from psychic mediums, afterlife researchers, and ordinary people who've had some inexplicable experiences. I think you'll be as surprised as I was about how just grounded these people are. That was one of the things that astounded me the most, and I'm really excited for you to come meet them too. I can't say I've drawn a final conclusion, but everything I've learned, and I'm still learning, is astounding enough and encouraging enough to keep me questioning my perceptions of the world. I hope you will join me in at least considering that the laws of our universe are much more complex than what we perceive with our five senses. So come, listen to me have normal conversations with normal people about really weird shit. Explore the possibilities of our universe and question, What the fuck just happened?